Before we get started, I want to bring some attention to our sound man. I've been doing this for 47 years, and when the sound is not good, everybody knows who the sound man is. When it's great, nobody knows until somebody tells you. Alan Maggard back there is one of the best in this business. When I know that Alan's there, I don't worry because I know the musicians are going to be happy. If they're happy, you're going to be happy. And if all of you guys are happy, I know I'm going to be happy. So really, give Alan an applause for what he does. Y'all ready? With that being said, I want you all to join with me and give a warm welcome to the Empty Bottle String Band.
Thank you. Lights there in Scott County, just next door to us. We're going to do one that AP collected out of St. Charles, Virginia. He was on a song trip looking for songs for the Carter family to record. He went down to St. Charles, which, like a lot of communities in Southwest Virginia, was a historic coal mining community, so it makes sense that he found this song down there. It's called Coal Miner's Blues.
Thank you.
Trey, get you a song here. A true story for us today. We were in Jonesboro, Tennessee this morning playing. We left Tennessee and come up here. So this is one called Leaving Tennessee.
Thank you. it's air circulating up here. Spin around as much as you want.
I tell you what, I ain't been sweating this much since Crystal got pulled over by the police last week. When we were riding around, we were on our way back from a gig. It was real late. And we were coming down this old mountain road in Kentucky, a little two-lane road. And Crystal, she's originally from the Lake of the Ozarks, Missouri. They race a lot of NASCAR drivers out there. So she's really hugging the curves and felt like we was on two wheels a time or two. And we come around the curve and all of a sudden the blue lights come on behind us. This cop pulled us over in the wide spot there in the road. He walked up to the window and you could tell he was just itching to write a ticket. There probably hadn't been nobody on the road all night long. So he walked up to the window and Chris rolled down her window. And he said, ma'am, I've been waiting on you all night. Crystal looked right at him, right in his eye and said, well, officer, I got here just as fast as I could. She's one of my very best friends. She was one of the first folks that I met when I started college at East Tennessee State University. Also now a long time ago, it feels like. She, like I said, she's originally from the Lake of the Ozarks, Missouri, and she lives in Johnson City, Tennessee, and she's a wonderful guitarist and a wonderful singer, too. Please put your hands together for Crystal Harmon.
Thank you.
this festival celebrates two of Wise County and Southwest Virginia's most influential musicians and songwriters and artists, and all around good representatives of what it means to be a mountain person in Virginia. Oftentimes, though, we always shorten the name of this festival. Folks usually just call it the Dog Boggs Festival. And I always like to try and say the whole name, Dog Boggs and Kate Peter Sturgill Festival. Kate Peter Sturgill is a wonderful musician and incredible songwriter, and truly a real leader for women in traditional mountain music around Wise County. First Wise County Fiddlers Convention that was ever held. She put together a band that was the band leader, and they actually took first place at the courthouse in the lines. And like I said, she wrote a lot of beautiful songs. Probably her most well-known is a gospel song that John McCutcheon recorded when he was running around these parts a few years ago. So we're going to try to do that one for you today. If you know it, sing along. This is a beautiful one called Deep Settled Peace. Is really the one in charge She always says that leading the Empty Bottle String Band, closest thing out there to it is herding cats. And I sure believe it. There are rough bumps to try and get along all the time. But I met Stephanie at a Rhythm and Roots Festival a long time ago when I was about 14, which I know probably just looks like that was only a couple of years ago, but that was a longer time than a couple of years ago now. And when Stephanie met, a mutual friend introduced us and said, "Oh, Stephanie, you're going to want to meet Tyler. You guys are going to want to play music together one day." And so we met and spoke for a minute. And then she walked away, and unbeknownst to me, when Stephanie walked away, she said to herself, and she admits to this, she said, "I don't want to play music with that kid." And then a few years later, we'd meet at ETSU and became good buddies and decided to put a band together for a farmer's market. It was just supposed to be a one-off kind of thing. And somebody walked up to us at the farmer's market and said, "I'll pay a few hundred dollars to come sing at my graduation party." And the Empty Bottle String Band was born, and the rest is history, as they say. She's originally from Elizabethton, Tennessee. She lives in Lexington, Kentucky now. She is an award-winning pie baker, and the only gal I know that can whistle underwater, and a fabulous musician and vocalist, Miss Stephanie Jeter.
Thank you, Tyler. I see y'all laughing out there when we talk about how old we feel like we are, but I'll tell you, I had several women in my family that were grandmothers by the time they were my age, so, and I don't feel like I'm that old, but one of my high school friends sent her firstborn to college this year, so I am starting to feel old, but these guys keep me young. I'm going to sing a song about sinning.
This is the truth. This is called Sinful to Flirt.
Heart made of stone. They asked me to speak to him. John Fox's music and his contribution to the tradition. If you haven't listened to him much, you should definitely check him out. Tyler's going to do one for you here all by his lonesome. Sometimes we let him take the stage by himself. It's a really, really, really nice Doc Fox tune called Pretty Polly. I say it's really nice, but it's actually pretty bad, plot-wise. I won't spoil it for you.
Yeah, well, Doc Fox, like I said, was such an influential musician from Southwest Virginia, and he had such a unique style of banjo playing. He played with three fingers, which really predated bluegrass playing, and he always played in these really strange tunings, which gave his banjo this really bluesy kind of sound. And he made history as one of the first recording artists to actually be recorded in country, or what we later call old time bluegrass music. He predated the Carter family's recordings by about 4 years. He recorded for a couple of record companies that came through the region. So he was an incredible guy. He was a real rabble rouser in his younger days. For a while, he got run out of Wise County and had to live over across the state line until the sheriff retired over here. Then he came back and played music for a few more years. And as he got about middle age, he took a break and he went into the mines and worked in the mines for many, many years. And then later on in his life, when the folk music revival started up, several folks from all across the country got really interested in this music again. And folks like Mike Seeger started traveling down here and trying to get him out a little bit. And they were successful in that, got him out and had him touring around and telling his stories and singing his songs. I always had a lot of respect for Doc Boggs. A lot of times our favorite musicians, like Bill Monroe and Maybell Carter and Doc Boggs, a lot of times they get a lot of credit, but their teachers don't always get a lot of credit. And Doc always was quick to mention that he learned a lot of his banjo style from African-American blues musicians who lived around the coal camps here. There's several stories written down that he'd talk about. He would sneak out after the whole household went to bed, he'd sneak out as a teenager. And at that time, the coal camps were segregated, and so he'd sneak off to the segregated parts of the camp and try to listen in on the music parties of the local African-American musicians. So they had a real heavy influence on his music, as they did a lot of country music. And I think you can hear that pretty obviously in this banjo picking. So I'll try to recreate a little bit of it for you. This is his version of Pretty Polly. Well, I used to be a rambler, I stayed around in town. I used to be a rambler, I stayed around in town. I courted Pretty Polly, her beauty's never been found. Pretty Polly, Pretty Polly, over yonder she stands. line by. She wrapped her arms around him and began for to weep. She wrapped her arms around him and began for to weep. At length, pretty poorly, she fell asleep. Thank you. square dances. So just go ahead and be getting a partner in mind. You don't have to know what you're doing. You don't even have to like your partner. You dance with a complete stranger or somebody you don't even like. Maybe by the end of the dance, you'll change your feelings about it. But we're going to go ahead and get you in the mood to dance with one here called Dance All Night with a Bottle in Your Hand.
One big ring, we'll circle to the left and we'll move that thing.
partner in Promenade Round. When you get home, just stand your ground. Couple two, you take a swing. Couple two, you go back to back, and you take a little trip around the outside track. All the way around and all the way down. When they come home, swing your partner around. Everybody swing. All take hands in one big ring. Circle up. And back by the right. And into the center for a loop and a shout. One more time, turn them back out. Turn to your partner, shake right hands. Right, left, green, go, you know again. Partner and promenade, promenade and promenade, and around you go. Everybody home. Now couple three, you take a swing. And couple three, you go back to back, and you take a little trip around the outside track. By the rock, we'll dance all night. And into the center for a group and shout. One more time, and you turn them back out. Now turn to your partner, shake right hands. It's the right, left, green, go hand over hand. And meet your partner and promenade around. When you get home, just stand your ground. Couple four, you take a swing. Back and take a little trip around the outside track. All the way around and all the way down. Now everybody swing your partner around. Everybody swing. And we'll all take hands in one big ring. Circle up. And back by the right. And it's into the center for a group and shout. Shake right hand, it's right, left, grand. Hand over hand, heel over heel. The more we dance, the better we feel. Promenade. And now it's time to promenade. Hey, everybody home. Now couple one and three, take a swing. One and three, swing. One and three, swing. And one and three, go back to back. And you take a little trip around the outside track. Come on around, everybody home and swing your own head.